This is Andrea Lacerna. Born October 15, 1998. He's been in the water his whole life. He's 146 pounds, 5'8 in height, which is considered, in the athletic world, short. He lives in Thousand Oaks, California, a place where it rains about 10 days a year, 15 if we're lucky. The weather is perfect every day, the beach is about 15 minutes away, and Andre is currently living a California teenage life. Surfing has been a big part of Andre's life. It's actually a big culture around the world even, but most people don't know his history. It dates back into the 1700s. The native Hawaiians started this ancient culture. Let's take a little trip back in time. Meet the English and the native Hawaiians. In translation, the natives called it wave sliding. If everybody had an ocean across the USA, then everybody'd be surfing like California. You'd see them wearing their baggies, huarache sandals too, a bushy, bushy blonde hairdo, surfing USA. In 1778, the English invaded.
Tan people, let's take their land.
Just like most historical events in the world. In battle, the natives were no match for the English. 150 years later, A man named Duke brought back the culture of surfing and shared it with the entire world. He is the reason why surfing is what we have today. In this day and age, surfing has turned into a pure lifestyle. Andre's brother, Christian, and his best friend, Taylor, are both big influences in his life. They've both been surfing long enough to know a lot and talk about surfing.
Surfing to me is, it's kind of my balance. When I was a kid, it was just this source of fun where I was able to go to the beach with my family, and then as I got a little older, go to the beach with my friends, and it was just kind of like my time away from home. And then when I got even older and I ended up, you know, going to college and having a full-time job, it's just kind of that source of happiness and that source of balance in my life that keeps me healthy. And
I guess whenever I think of surfing, I think of it as a good release or like an outlet for me. Having a good time with my friends. I always know that whenever I go on the water, I pretty much never have a bad time out there, so.
Surfing is definitely more than just a hobby. You know, not only is it this sport that, you know, a lot of people, you know, put their time into, and it really takes a lot of effort, I'd say, to surf, because, you know, you have to buy the board, and boards are, what, $600 to $800. Sometimes if you're getting a really nice longboard, they're over $1,000. Wetsuits are over $200, and it's just a very expensive sport. So if you're really into it, it's overall just like, already, it's more than just a hobby, because it means something to you that you're putting in all of this money and time towards. It's also, it is a lifestyle, 100%. You meet people out in the water, you connect with people in life.
Like when you find out a buddy of yours surfs that you didn't know does that. It's always cool, and you know, right when you say like, oh, I surf too, it's instantly you connect. And
there are a ton of benefits when you surf. Not only are there health benefits, you are staying fit and active. You're almost being one with nature, and that sounds completely cliche, but it's so true. There is no other sport like surfing where Mother Nature literally pushes you through its element and you're able to make something out of it. It's honestly insane. Like, you can't do that with a tennis court. No offense to any tennis players. And you can't do that with a basketball court or a soccer field. I'm not dumping on team sports at all, but what I'm saying is it's a very personal thing. But there's also, you know, that bond with the community and that whole lifestyle and that vibe you get just from being part of it.
Andre surfing. Let's talk about Andre.
Okay, so I've been surfing with this kid since he was 12 years old, I think. I introduced him to surfing, and he's a crack up. It's a lot of fun to surf with him. He's one of the only kids that will burn me. He'll burn me, and then I'll get him back. It's a lot of fun.
Because he's my brother, I'm always feeling like whenever I go out with Andre, it's like a game between us, like who can outsurf the other one. If he catches a wave and I see him like do some turns or going, you know, all the way down the line, I always have to beat him. I have to do the bigger turns. I have to end up farther than him.
We're not competitive. Honestly, I wouldn't say that we're super competitive with each other, but we're just out there to like have a good time. Like I'll see him take off on a wave and I'll just yell for him. Give him a holler. He's always stoked. He is literally most of the time the first one in the water. And he's the last one out. There have been plenty of times where I've had to yell at that kid to get out because I'd be late for work.
Surfing is probably the only thing that he'll get up at 4 a.m. to do. Whenever he has like practice in the morning, never wakes up for his alarm, but hear the alarm go off at 4 a.m. for a surf, he's the first one up, waking me up, and I'm just in bed waiting for him to go back to sleep. I know that fool loves to surf a lot, maybe more than I do.
No, Andre, you're the little punk, but I enjoy surfing with you, and we're gonna go on some rad trips in the future. But it's so much fun, and it's so great to be a part of something and to just share that connection with, you know, your friends. It's great.
Surfing has taken a huge impact in people's lives, especially Andre's. It brings people together, and it's all about having fun. Positive vibes, physical and social benefits. The life in the water is truly a remarkable one.
Two tabs on your tongue. I heard the shepherds, I heard the sheep sleep. Now my only one. Broken sweethearts, oh, who sleep apart. Lost to find the inside spines, who must sleep out. Now shush, she makes the sound that she makes to calm me down.